I say this a lot. God won't put it in your lap, but he'll always put it in your reach. And we have to always be reaching.
Say that again. That is powerful. God won't put it
God will not put it in your lap. He'll always put it in your reach. Because when you think about it, God's trying to raise mature believers, not spoiled brats. And spoiled brats, I think we have, at least in America, I think we have a lot of spoiled brat Christians who are used to getting everything they want when they want it. And it's more of an American mindset than a kingdom mindset.
Yeah.
I don't see God operating that way. I see God putting things within our reach because he wants to bless us. He wants to work miracles through us.
Yeah.
But if we're not willing to reach, we got the wrong attitude about the kingdom of God. So God will always put it, never put it in our lap, but he'll put it in our reach.
Every miracle I've seen in my life, and man, it's amazing. What, for those that are watching, we have no plan when we come on the air. It's just the whole point of this program is to have someone to revelate with, to bounce off and excite each other in the spirit, to find a theme from heaven. And what is blowing my mind is as you're talking, I'm amazed, and I can feel so strongly that there are pastors watching me just now, Craig, and they're living in the world of repossessions. They're living in the foreclosure world. And let me tell you, God lives in that world. God lives in the world of failure. This may shock you. God lives in the world of failure. Everything it starts out seems to start out in the negative, in the dark, and you wonder, oh my goodness, you know, why? How am I here? You're sitting with, you know, a building that you're about to be booted on the street, and the devil's thinking, I got him, and God's saying, I got him, and two exact same statements. One is for destruction. One is to give you your inheritance. And the devil wants you to be so fearful and paralyzed. What I've learned in my life is fear paralyzes. Fear will stop you from seeing beyond the panic of the moment. The winners, the champions, are the guys that see beyond the crisis.